Thanks to Magellan TV for sponsoring today's video. With the James Webb Space Telescope nearing its launch, I felt like it would be a good idea to have another look at some of the remarkable images of its predecessor, the Hubble Space Telescope. Hubble has been in space for 30 years now and has increased our understanding of the universe drastically during this time. A type of object Hubble has observed is galaxies. Galaxies, as we've seen earlier in this series, come in all different shapes and sizes, with star populations ranging from millions to the trillions. They are fascinating, beautiful objects, each containing its own story of how they formed the way they did, let alone the tantalizing question about the possibility of life somewhere in them. While we have only observed the tiniest fraction of the total number of galaxies in the observable universe up close, did you know that Hubble has seen galaxies all the way through their evolution, from galaxies in the throes of starbirth or starburst, to galaxies that are inert, anemic, or dying? I'm Alex McColgan, and you're watching Astrum, and today I wanted to look through this spectrum of galaxy evolution, focusing today on the ghostly, beautiful remnants of galaxies that are on their way out. I hope by the end of this video to have earned your like and subscription. When looking at a galaxy, the first indicator of the stage of its evolution is to look at its shape. It is generally believed that spiral and barred galaxies are some of the least evolved galaxies in the universe, whereas elliptical galaxies are the most evolved. That doesn't necessarily mean spiral and bar galaxies are younger though, it's just that they take longer to evolve. Here's an example. Number 68, NGC 2336. Galaxies with spirals consist of flat disks, where stars mainly orbit in the same direction. One of their defining characteristics are the arms that extend from the galaxy center. These arms can spiral out directly from the galaxy's core, or sometimes the spirals come from a bar. They consist of a concentration of stars, gas, and dust. Galaxies that have an abundance of dust are likely not as far along the evolution process as less dusty galaxies, as this dust has yet to be turned into new stars. Should no outside influence accelerate the dust consumption, a galaxy like this may produce stars at a fairly slow but steady rate for billions of years yet. How do we know it's not producing stars very quickly? Well, a distinct feature about this galaxy is the lack of red H2 regions, or stellar nurseries. Instead, while star formation is clearly still taking place due to all the bright blue stars you can see in this image, it will remain as a spiral galaxy for a lot longer than a galaxy bright with H2 regions. Like number 69, NGC 972. Wow, what a pretty galaxy. It almost looks like it's ablaze with all the activity happening around it. When a galaxy is so red, we characterize it as a starburst galaxy. That is to say, star formation is happening at an incredible rate. These red regions are the H2 regions the previous galaxy was missing an abundance of. As starburst continues, it will quickly use up the gas and dust structures you see here, converting it all to stars. Also, notice the blue glow like a halo around the galaxy. The blue hue comes from blue stars, the hottest and most massive star type. This is another indicator of rapid star formation, as these stars require huge amounts of matter to fall into them during their formation. Number 70, Messier 61. Another incredible example of a starburst galaxy is M61. M61 is a fantastic galaxy for observation because it's angled almost exactly face onto us. This means all the dust lanes and its red nebulae can be studied in detail. That's a lot harder to do with a galaxy that's edge on. Looking closely at the center of the galaxy shows a neat symmetry with the dust lanes. However, the further out you zoom, the more you notice how it becomes less symmetrical. This arm seems to split into three, whereas this one retains its structure. Usually, an asymmetrical galaxy indicates that it is being perturbed in some way, either from the gravitational influence of a nearby galaxy or from an actual collision with one. In this case, M61 is actually found 50 million light years away in the heart of the Virgo cluster, surrounded by over 1,000 galaxies. It's this outside influence that likely causes starbursts to happen and for a galaxy to accelerate its evolution, as this outside tug of gravity causes the dust clouds within the galaxy to collapse in on themselves, creating stars. Number 71, NGC 4921. All galaxies will eventually exhaust their supply of gas and dust as they get converted to stars, and then neutron stars or black holes. A small percentage of gas and dust also gets consumed by the supermassive black hole believed to exist at the center of every sizable galaxy. What happens to a galaxy then? Well, NGC 4921 is a good example of a galaxy about to transition into what is known as a lenticular galaxy. However, this one still has its spiral arms visible, so it remains classified as a spiral galaxy for now. It seems that star formation and dust lanes are a key element of keeping the shape of a spiral galaxy's arms, and when this process stops and the material runs out, the arms seem to lose some of their shape and definition. The color of the galaxy also changes to a ghostly white or reddish white as the galaxy's blue star population burns out and disappears. This is a fascinating galaxy. It is really unusual to see a spiral galaxy so devoid of color. The only colors visible really are the few remaining blue stars clinging to the dust lanes. Astronomers have described this galaxy as anemic, as star formation here must be incredibly slow. Number 72, NGC 2217. This is the first true lenticular galaxy I've shown you today, although NGC 2217 isn't totally done with star formation just yet. Notice the blue stars around the outer edge of the galaxy. However, in this instance, the dust here is almost completely exhausted, and the spiral arms have lost their definition. The bulge at the center of the galaxy has a white and reddish hue, showing that only older and less massive star types exist here. There are no blue stars visible to speak of. Number 73, PGC 10922. Here's another face-on galaxy for you. This particular lenticular galaxy is further along its evolution again. Most of the galaxy here is completely devoid of gas and dust, apart from towards the center. You'll also notice how any arms that once existed have been totally wound up until they are almost indistinguishable. All that's left really are old stars and a flat disk, but even the disk will eventually lose its shape as the galaxy widens and evolves into an elliptical galaxy. Like what is happening with number 74, NGC 1947. With this lenticular galaxy, we can still see the wispy remnants of the spiral arms. However, the stars in this galaxy have clearly already stopped orbiting along a flat disk, and now simply orbit slowly and from all directions. The very last stages of a lenticular galaxy look something like NGC 1533. There's no gas or dust noticeable. However, you can just about see the remains of a bar structure coming away from the core, indicating that this was once a barred spiral galaxy. Eventually, what you end up with is something like number 76, Messier 105. This is a true elliptical galaxy, a galaxy almost totally devoid of gas and dust. This galaxy is so anemic that only one sun-like star gets produced in a galaxy like this every 10,000 years. So what you are left with is the vast majority of the stars found in this galaxy being older, redder star types. If we really zoom into this image, you can see the red sprinkling of stars, especially as we move away from the brightness of the galaxy's core. This is the last stage of a galaxy's evolution that we can observe. These stars will last for billions to trillions of years, and the universe is too young to see what happens eventually to a galaxy like this, although it is thought that they will simply become dimmer and dimmer as one by one the stars reach the end of their lives. So there we have it, a snapshot of the evolution of galaxies. While having an almost spooky vibe to them, I really like lenticular galaxies. Their unstable nature produces some amazing patterns that you can't find in any other galaxy type. Although it is somewhat sad to think too, that as the universe ages, spiral galaxies will become less and less common, until the only galaxy type remaining are the elliptical galaxies. Although we are long due for an upgrade to Hubble, it is really still a feat of engineering, and it's been really interesting to me to learn about the telescope itself. Magellan TV has an amazing documentary called Hubble Eye in the Sky about the behind the scenes of Hubble, how the mission team operates it, and some of the obstacles it has to overcome. For instance, the South Atlantic anomaly, which is really quite fascinating and something I didn't know about before. Magellan TV has the most varied science content available anywhere, with over 3,000 documentaries, a lot of which is available in 4K, and you can watch them with no ads and from pretty much any device. If you want to watch this Hubble documentary and more like it, you can use my link in the description to try Magellan TV for free for a whole month. So you should definitely give it a go, I highly recommend it. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, be sure to have a look at the rest of the videos in this Hubble playlist here. A big thanks as always to my patrons and members. If you found value in this video and want to help support the channel to make more like this, check the links in the description. All the best and see you next time.